But in the next couple of minutes, joining me now to make sense of all of this as public affairs analyst, Smart Akwejoye. Good morning, Smart. Good to see you.
Good morning, Mike, and great. Good to see you too.
Good to see you. All right. Now, the president made a strong statement on Twitter. However, yesterday, Twitter went, abuzz with a lot of comment and reaction after Twitter took down the president's comment, where he was making, issuing out the warning to those who were perpetrating, all of the acts across the country. What do you make of the statement of the president, especially when he's saying that we will, give them, we'll talk in the language, we'll give it to them in the language they understand?
First, let me say something clearly. I'm a Nigerian, I'm a Yoruba man. I will never support any sections of this country calling for a breakup. I will never. Whatever it will take to make Nigeria one must be put in place. Secondly, Mr. President was elected as the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. And what I expect him to do is that at every point in time that he's making a statement, he must be making a statement as the President of Federal Republic of Nigeria. And as the President of Federal Republic of Nigeria, as the father, first, because of his age, again, no father threatens the child or his children. The statement from Mr. President referring to civil war. As far as I'm concerned, yes, civil war happened in Nigeria, but then civil war has been erased, has been deleted from our memory. We must not even, nobody in public office, a public office holder, should even make reference to talking about civil war. Mr. President talking about civil war is a reminder of the fact that he is seeing this nation, perhaps the president of one part of the nation, and another part of the district, so which is wrong. That statement coming from Mr. President is extremely very, very wrong. I know nobody, he will not send out an apology and he will never see anything wrong. That is why sometimes when they call, Mr. President should address us. I don't want him to address us, because sometimes when he talk, his words are not comforting. Moving forward, you see, what I expect Mr. President to do now, or what I would have done if I am sitting in his position, is that perhaps I will leave Aso Rock.
Where would you leave Aso Rock?
I will leave Aso Rock to, I will just call all the governors in the south, in the southeast, and say, please, let's choose Enugu or Ebonyi or Imo as our convergence point. I will go, I say, bring all your opinion leaders, bring all your traditional leaders, and you, all the governors, I will go with all members of the House of Assembly, House of Rep, all the chairmen of all the elected chairmen, or perhaps acting chairmen, or whatever they call themselves, bring all of them together. I'll say, look, your people have been doing this. What do they really want? First, me as Mr. President, I will never accept a breakup. What you are calling for a Biafra or whatever, we can never have it. Now, why are you asking for this? What is the problem? I want to know the problem. Because perhaps what I am seeing as the problem might not be what you,
But the president stated clearly that he receives security reports on daily basis, which means when it comes to understanding what the problem is, the details of the problem, the president receives the best and the most detailed security reports.
I disagree with you, sir.
Okay.
He said he received a daily report of happenings. That means he received a daily report of the attacks on police stations, government facilities, INEC, whatever.
Yeah.
He has not been receiving. Why are these people attacking it?
No,
that's what I'm concerned.
The national security advisor is the one who aggregates, or who is meant to aggregate all of these security reports from across the country.
Yes, he receives security
and
reports.
And sees them for the president. So the president receives all the reports. So he's in the best position to understand
what
whatever.
I expect, Mr. President. Look, if a child is crying always, there must be something making that child to cry. So you as a father, What you should do is that maybe that child have his own room. He's always crying. I mean, whenever he cries, he goes back to his room. What you should do as a father is to leave your room and go and stay with that child. Oh yeah, call him by it. Give him a pet name. Give him a sweet name. Say, what is the problem? Why are you always crying? Why are you always disturbing? Whenever, anytime you cry, you are not handsome. Anytime you cry, you're not beautiful. I want to know why you are always crying. Listen to that child. And then you might not be able to address that child's problem.
But at least to have come to the child's room.
Come to the child's room and ask questions. You will give that child some sense of belonging. Maybe what that child needs is just attention. See, what we have today is because we have a president that has alienated himself from the people. Look, when all the other presidents, they will go on state visits, I am not sure this president in his 6 years, going to 7 years now, has visited 10 states or maybe just courtesy visit. Let me just come and visit you, except if perhaps he's invited to come and commission a project. Go and sit with the governor, meet with the opinion leaders. It does not, what does it take to visit the all 36 states in a year? Sit with them, listen to them, collect what their problem is. If you cannot solve it, for the fact that you have listened to them, you have collected it, you have given them the assurance that, okay, it's in the pipeline. Solving it is in the pipeline, but you're not doing that. You're issuing a threat. You cannot issue a threat to Nigeria. And at every time again you issue threats, that threat will never, look, the problem gets escalated the more. Obasanjo did something. When Asahi Dokubo was doing or whatever, Obasanjo said he had so many options. But he said, okay, let me invite this boy. He sent a private jet to go and pick him, bring him to Aso Rock. He had a meeting with him. He said at that time that even when they went to pick him, he had two options again. He said either to detain him or listen to him. He said he listened to him. Obasanjo did not solve their problem. But because he listened to him, that doused the tension a little bit. What I expect Mr. President to do is not to sit in Aso Rock and be issuing threats. Go with all the APC members that are in your government. Go with all government functionaries that are in your government that are from the southeast. Go with them. Say, look, this one is from Sozo Place. This one is from Sozo Place. They are all working with me. If anything is your problem, let me know. I want to listen to you. I want to solve this problem. And do you know one thing? Why Mr. President is failing us so much? And why somebody like me, I feel so disappointed in him, Mr. PMB, is because of the fact that I put so much resources, both financial, moral, and human resources, campaigning from him. Not even when he joined the APC, but even from his days in ANPP and CPC. Records are there. Now, because I did this so much, because I believe so much in him, he now came and became the president that has disappointed me the more. The simple fact is that this president is not even addressing issues. A good example was during the NSAS. We were expecting him to make a comforting statement. The statement he even made even aggravated the NSAS protest the more. You see, you cannot continue to live a life like that. We cannot continue to live a life like this. In Nigeria today, there are problems of insecurity, which have led to the problem of scarcity of high cost of inflation because of agriculture. We are not doing well in agriculture. This government with this guy, CBN governor, came up with so many proposals or so many ideas that will boost agriculture. Is CBN doing that today?
But they have the anchor borrowers.
They don't have any anchor borrower. Let CBN come today and say, look, let them give Nigerians, and that if they dispute it, please react to it. Nassau, this agri-miss loan was one of the fantastic ones that would have galvanized agriculture. For the past 1 year or going to 2 years, there have not been any disbursement, even for those that they have interviewed. Now, leave that again. The anchor borrower, as far as I'm concerned, sitting here today, I can tell you that if we properly harness our potentials in agriculture, Nigerians will be calling people to come and work from other West African countries. Agriculture alone will employ all Nigerians because there are value chains in agriculture.
Yeah, exactly.
Which we're not addressing. Now, the insecurity issue, I keep saying that if we want to address insecurity issue in this country, the only thing you need today is the political will. Is the government willing to address insecurity problem? We will address it. You cannot be addressing the security problem from Abuja. Security problem are community based. Hmm. Let us tackle it from
local.
Give it to the ballet, CDA chairman, the OBAS and the DPUs.
But we have seen situations where reports come out that the traditional rulers at some level, in some of the reports we've got here and there, sometimes are even in abate crimes sometimes.
Yes.
What are situations
now, let me tell you, you cannot have an 100% this thing, security, whatever.
Compliance.
There must be some shafts.
Okay.
Now, what do we do? If the Oba is aiding security, the ballet might not be. The community leaders might not be. So somewhere along the line, they will get who is aiding the crime, and they will get him off. They don't have immunity. Nobody has immunity apart from the elected president and governor.
Chief executive.
That have immunity. If you commit crime, if we know that you have committed crime, you will be arrested. To solve security problem in this country. Do you know if we solve security problem in this country, we won't have problem. We won't even, they said COVID came up. What is COVID? We won't have any problem at all with financing our economy. Because in the first place, either COVID or whatever, we have our agriculture, people must eat. Mm. Our agriculture alone will run very successfully. But it's because we have this security problem. That is why the son of the farmer in the village has gone to take his father. Say, please come to Lagos where I know you are safe. Or come to the city where I know you are safe. Mm. You are no more safe in this place. There are so many things that this government, when President Buhari was campaigning, he came up with so many things. But virtually everything he campaigned of, none has come into existence. Are we talking about the health system? The health system is in comatose. Are we talking about today? Thank God that they are coming up with what is it called? Concessioning of roads. Mm. The federal government has no business going to borrow money to construct roads. All it could have done is that map out all the federal government federal roads and concession it. Okay. All you just need to do with the concessionaire is come up with the structural engineering plan and let them go ahead. All you need to do again, employ every community, villages, towns that passes through all these places. Mm. Employ their able-bodied guys as security for this corridor.
So they own it.
So as far as I'm concerned, we don't have problem. Okay. The problem that we have is the fact that we have government that are clueless and does not know what they are doing. Rulers instead of leaders, because if you're a leader, you will lead well. But if you're a ruler, you will rule the way you want.
All right. Smart, let's leave it here now. There are so many things we need to talk about when it comes to the challenges bedeviling Nigeria here and there. But time will not permit us now, but I know we'll create time to talk more. Thank you very much, Smart Akrejo.
Thank you, Mike, for having me. Thank you, and I appreciate it.
Right.